testimony of Alvaro Hernandez, from the city of Caracas, Venezuela. The year 1995 revelations to the General Church, important notice. The Church is in danger. God be praised that the peace of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit has come into every heart. I thank God for this good preparation of being here with the brothers. My soul rejoices before God. I want to tell you that we are not God's preferred people unless we are a church that lives in holiness. I was praying to God at dawn and my soul was taken up to Him. When I looked, I was faced with a being of light. The angel of the Lord came to fetch me, and together we descended into the valley of darkness, which I believe is hell. There is the place of perdition where people who have lost the way of salvation and never found it, people who get lost in drugs, alcohol and have not been able to find the truth, they did not know what to do with their lives. There in hell no one even finds himself standing near one another. There is no way out nor escape from the demons. They are eternally lost and will never find the end of this place. Perdition means ruin, doom or destruction. People who walk lost in the wrong ways when they die are lost in hell. The souls that are there have been forgotten by God. On earth God sends rain. The sun makes the tree bear fruit for people to eat. The earth produces food for the people and the air provides the oxygen to breathe. We have a bed to sleep on and a blanket to heat. It all is the sign that God loves mankind and has never forgotten. In hell there is no day, food, water, oxygen to breathe. There is no rain, no sun and no tree of fruit. This is the sign that God has abandoned these lost souls. I was walking with the angel in hell. The demon showed me a machine that produces a variety of men's and women's shorts. He said these shorts will rise to the earth. It is the new fashion that will arise. Warn them on earth that if they do not stop wearing my shorts, their souls will land in hell when they die. Women also should stop wearing our thongs. The devil has called several other demons with different haircuts to come forward. Female and male haircuts, he said. This is our fashion that is being launched on earth. I noticed several radical haircuts, some with designs at the nape of the neck, haircuts with designs on the head, cuts with satanic symbols taking away the image of God. I have seen women believers in hell by cutting their hair. They have cut off the covenant symbol from their heads. I saw in hell brothers who made fashionable haircuts, extravagant cuts that call attention. Other women are in hell because they painted their nails. The demons cut off the fingers of these sisters. And the ones that painted the hair, the demons plucked the scalp and left the sisters bald. Those who wore lipsticks had their lips cut from their mouths, becoming only the skeleton. Those who wore earrings had their ears cut off. I only saw two holes instead of the ears. Those who wore makeup had their faces melted with fire. Those wearing necklaces had their necks serrated. I saw sisters in hell for wearing short skirts whose hems were above their knees, and I also saw women wearing dresses clinging tightly to their bodies. I saw Christian men who wore tight clothing on their bodies. I saw sisters in hell for wearing cracked skirts and high heels. I saw those who walked without shirts. I saw brothers who are in hell for wearing sleeveless shirts, and those who wear shorts at home like normal clothes and go out to the street. And all these I saw are brothers of various denominations. Bodybuilding. I saw brothers in hell who did bodybuilding to attract attention and glances to their bodies. They wanted to stay strong to wear tight clothing. This is the true doctrine that has been revealed to me. Adultery. The angel said, "You think there is no one from your church in this place?" The angel took me to a place where I saw a sister from my church. She died 5 years ago. I was scared to see this sister there. The angel said, "She is here because she wanted the husband of another woman." I saw an old man in hell. The angel said, "He is here for wanting a young girl from his church. He being married committed adultery in his heart by betraying his wife." I did not believe in seeing people from the fellowship there. The angel showed me a sister who had impure thoughts, fantasized and imagined having sex in her mind. She was single and committed fornication in her mind with a picture of a boy. I saw a couple of brothers who are there because of the eroticism. The man wore sex fantasies like the Superman, and his wife who is also in that place wore a Jaguar costume. I saw Christian women there for indulging in sexual fantasies. They introduced objects into their private parts. When they got to hell, their private parts were tormented by the demons. The angel showed me a sodomite industry of sexual objects, clothes, and fantasies. The angel showed me a deacon who is the for envy. He wanted a car just like his brother in church. I saw a man in hell for mistreating animals. He had the pleasures of killing cats. I saw a pastor in hell for using the media to attack the true churches, defaming the servants of God. I saw brothers who were drunk with wine and beer. Their imprisoned souls were being punished for their sins. A demon was circulating through hell but pretended not to be a demon. He was multifaceted and turned into several people who were trapped in hell. The angel said, he assumes the appearance of the souls that are in this place and rises the earth to deceive the spiritists, saying that it is the person. That demon took the name of that person and went to earth. That demon became a man, woman, child, cat, dog, an angel. He has a great ability to take on looks. I was watching the wiles of that demon. Suddenly I heard a great burst, an earthquake in hell that shook the demons. The angel said, those who have caused this great shaking in hell are members of a church that is praying at dawn. The angel took me out of hell and led me to the church that was praying at that moment. Then the angel took me to a Christian home, and the guardian angel who took care of him left him in that house because the couple slept naked, and a terrible demon approached them to torment them. The angel said, the tithe is not of the law. Before the law was given through Moses, tithes already existed. Genesis chapter 14 verse 20 gave him a tenth of everything. He lived by faith, not by law, and all who walk in grace become children of the faith of Abraham, just as Abraham gave tithes to the king of Salem, who is Melchizedek. The church also has to have the same attitude toward Jesus. Melchizedek symbolized Jesus in the Old Testament. After this revelation, I began to tithe. No one is required to know the amount of money you offer. If your elder does not agree, but you can give the tithe. He cannot prevent and also will not ask how much will be offered. I am tithing and no one has ever known until today. The angel handed me a sword. When I took that sword I felt the weight and could not lift it. The angel said, this is the weight of the word that will carry you. You cannot handle this sword today because you do not read the word, but tomorrow you will have the ability to handle the word in force enough to lift. Today you will receive the gift of dreams just as Joseph had, and I will speak with you through dreams. Now go back to your body. I returned to earth and began to pray, and the Holy Spirit revealed to me 13 kinds of people in the church. At night I prayed and went to sleep, and for the first time, I had a revelation in the dream. An angel appeared in my dream and said he will reveal to me about 13 temples or house. Everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash. The angel took to visit temple or house that a representation of believers, house number one, the abode of demons. The angel said, I will show you how the spiritual houses or lives of every Christian in your congregation are. The angel took me to the first house. It was a dark house, and we entered into it. When we started walking in it, we found rats, insects, cockroaches and flyworms. A great stench of carrion flooded the house. I walked with the angel in several rooms of the house and always found insects. The house was messy and abandoned. I entered a part of that house and a snake jumped in my direction to inject its venom. I was able to dodge in time, and farther ahead of the house we found a lot of snakes together. I asked the angel, where was that? Where are we? The angel took me out of that house and carried me up into the air. The angel answered me, they are the spiritual houses of the members of your congregation. They have their interiors filled with the abodes of demons. Their hearts are dark and full of sin. This house where you were symbolizes the lives of some members of your church. I said, how can it be? We are a holy people. My church will go up to heaven. The angel said, there is no collective salvation. Where there is wheat there are also the tares. House 2, abode of media. The angel took me to the second house. As I entered, I noticed that the house was full of irons with two-headed fireworks resembling Olympic torches. Those irons were standing illuminating every corner of that house. The house was full of large cracks that are open to the view of the street. A strong wind came in the house and extinguished those torches of fire, and everything went dark. A few minutes later, bats began to enter together with a swarm of grasshoppers into that house as a result of darkness. That house was uncomfortable because of the noise of those grasshoppers and bats. The angel said, "The house that you saw had seven fires, which are the candlesticks symbolizing the presence of the Holy Spirit. The wind that entered the house and put out the flames is the influence of the world that had entered the lives of the believers. When the world had entered the lived of the believers, the flames of the Holy Spirit faded and the oil was gone, leaving the life of the believer in darkness. Sin has begun to envelop the saved. Sin entered in the life of the believers and settled inside their homes through the media. True Christians are not known publicity and have no connection with the satanic media. Television was created to offer fame, money and to exalt men as stars of the world. Satan has given this power to those who follow him. Jesus refused all this on earth when Satan offered him the proposal in the wilderness. Christians of evangelical programming sold themselves to become famous in the media. House 3, Abode of Sin. The angel took me to the third house. A strong wind shook the foundation and the roof began to fall. The house collapsed all over, and that strong wind was infested with buzzards entered inside this house. The angel said, "This is the end for all believer who remain in sin despite all the warning. Those vultures symbolize the powers of destruction. These kinds of people are not strongly founded and based on the word, but they are found in the churches." House 4, Abode of Evil. The angel took me to the fourth house, and there was a man in black in front of the door. The door opened wide for the black-robed man who looked like a vampire. That man entered. I was afraid to go into the house. The angel said, "Fear not, he will not see us." When we entered the house, I saw this man destroying the whole house with a sword. All the furniture in that house was destroyed. The man lit a torch to light the house. The fire was red. That fire symbolizes the evil presence. House 5, Abode of Seduction. The angel took me to the fifth house. The resident there was a very beautiful woman. She was dressed in a short tight dress, her red lips glowed. She was sexy and seductive, looking like a model. Inside this house, there were many colored lights that flashed, and they looked like a party house of songs and dances. The angel brought me out of the house, and outside the house were many designs, paintings: pink, red, black, blue and purple. They were six colors that adorned that house, symbolizing some of the numbers of the beast, which is six. The house was flashy. The angel said, "That woman is the seducing demon that dwells within the temples of many women of his church. He settles inside them and changes their personalities, making them sexier and more attractive. Their interiors are sensually appealing, making them appear as such in their appearances. The works of the heart are manifest in the flesh. A woman who lives this way does not have a clean interior and lives with her heart stained with lasciviousness. The women of the church are imitating this demon of the beauty you saw. It means that they are being controlled by this demon." House 6, Abode of Aged Spirituality. The angel took me to the sixth house. It was a very old, finished house full of holes. Inside this house was a group of men in their white uniforms. They repaired the house and closed those crevices with cement and then painted that house in white on the outside, and inside the house, they did a makeover, leaving the house perfect. This house was without light, but those men would put on electricity and the light lighted up the whole house. The angel said, "These men you saw are the angels who work on earth, reforming the lives of those who have been in the church and grown in age. Spiritually, they no longer felt the presence of God, but now they will be renewed and restored it to the lost glory. The bright color you saw in the house is their justification through Jesus." House 7, Abode of Holy Spirit. The angel took me to the seventh house. There was a lot of fierce animal noises inside. I was afraid to enter, yet I trusted the angel. The angel prevented me from entering and stood at the door. Inside in this house I could hear the noises of wild animal. It was scary. Then a man in white dressed like a priest came to the door. He entered the house and all the wild animals left, fleeing from his presence. The alien-like animals were expelled from that house. This priest cast out those demons and took all the dirt out of that house, threw away the old things and scented the whole house with sweet aroma. The rotten stench disappeared, and a scent of perfume flooded the house. The angel said, "Let us enter," and that priest kindled the fire candle of that house and put a sign with letters of gold that said, "Here the thief does not enter." That priest locked the door and prepared a supper table for me and the angel. We sat at the table with the priest. Later a monsters knocked on the door to get in, but it was locked. Those monsters could not get in and they left. The angel said, "When Jesus comes back, whoever has the seal of the flame of the Holy Spirit will be taken up with him. This is the mark of those who have the Holy Spirit in their lives, and do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, in whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Get rid of all bitterness, rage and anger, outcry and slander, along with every form of malice." House 8, Abode of the Word. The angel took me to the eighth house. It was being built by a man. When he finished building the house, a great earthquake destabilized its columns, its structures and bases could not withstand the quake and the house fell. The angel said, "Any life that is built on the doctrines of men will not withstand trials." When he told me this, a group of working angels took all the stones from the rubble and started rebuilding the house. The walls with the pillars were lifted once more and stood firm. Another great earthquake came and shook the house, but it stood firm and standing. That house was repaired and restored after it fell. Its condition was perfect compared to the first state. The angel said, "When lives are built on the foundations of the Word of God, they resist the tempest because the Word abides forever. And if trials cause wounds, they will bind and heal because of the word that is abounding within. This book of the law must not depart from your mouth. You are to recite it day and night, so that you may carefully observe everything written in it. For then you will prosper and succeed in all you do." I saw the angels closing the cracks in the house caused by the earthquake. House 9, Abode of Jesus. The angel took me to the ninth house. It was being bombed. Millions of modern weapons were fired at that house. They looked like machine guns that did not stop unloading and shooting at that house. That house received cannon shots and bombs, but nothing happened to its structures. On the contrary, the base of the house was strengthened. The angel said, "Even if the demons attack those who are firm and rooted in Jesus, they will not succeed in destroying a house built on the Word. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is Him. He will be like a tree planted by the waters that sends out its roots toward the stream. It does not fear when the heat comes, and its leaves are always green. It will not worry in a year of drought or cease producing fruit." House 10, Abode of the Blood. The angel took me to the tenth house. In front of her, on the doorposts of her door, was stained with blood. The window was open and the sun was radiating inside the house through the window. A dark angel with a sickle in his hand looked at the house in order to enter and cause death and destruction. However, when the angel of destruction and death saw the blood, he could not enter. He walked away from this house. The angel of the Lord said, "All the life that has the mark of Jesus' blood is saved and covered with grace. The sun you saw is that of justice and symbolizes Jesus. By faith Moses left Egypt, not fearing the king's anger. He persevered because he saw him who is invisible. By faith he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of blood, so that the destroyer of the firstborn would not touch Israel's own firstborn." House 11, Abode of Transformation. The angel took me to the 11th house. That it was ugly, crooked and out of place. The angels with their sledgehammers began to destroy that house. Everything was demolished: bases, columns, and structures. The angel rebuilt and made that house perfect. The foundations were spiritual. I've never seen such a structure on earth. It was a heavenly home. Everything was redone with perfect measurements. The bases were right. The priest in white at the sight of this beautiful house came to live inside. The angel said, "God's transformation is perfect in every person's life. All that demolition is a painful process that is part of the change in man. Consider it pure joy, my brothers, when you encounter trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Allow perseverance to finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything." House 12, Abode of Holiness. The angel took me to the 12th house. This house shone because hundreds of lights were coming from within. The angel said, a holy life before God makes the believer the light of the world. House 13, Abode of Legal. Demonic entrance. The angel took me to the 13th house. A black shadow was knocking on the door. The house was perfect and there was nothing wrong with it. The door of the house opened on its own and the shadow entered. The angel said, even if the Christian lives a holy life, by lack of prudence he can still legally open the door of his heart out of his own free will for the demons to dwell inside him. The heart of man is deceitful. I woke up from that dream, that was the revelation of the prayers of the dawn. I want to speak to all who slander the brotherhood calling it a sect, beware of your tongues. If it were a sect Jesus would have told me. The church is holy, so far we have not let worldly praises enter our temples. Worldly praises are praises of human beings sung by singers who are not converted and who call themselves Christians. We are not perfect and we have doctrinal errors like any other church. The only one who is 100%